We're going to meet with Dr. Hassan Abu Talib, head of Al Ahram Regional Institute for Press. He has a history that he'd like to share with us.
My name is Hassan Abu Talib. I have a PhD in international relations from Cairo University since 1995. I'm now working as a director of Al Ahram Institute for Journalism. And also I'm a consultant of Center for Political and Strategic Studies in Al Ahram Foundation since 1977. I was appointed here in Al Ahram after 1 month after finishing my military services. And all this period I was in Center for Political and Strategic Studies until 1998, and after that I moved for Emirate for 1 year, and then I back to Cairo and continue working in Al Ahram Center for Political and Strategic Studies until 2009, when I moved from the center to the Institute for Journalism. Our institute is in concerning about training in media and journalism, and also in preparing all the people who want to be a journalist to be a journalist. And now we have a lot of training courses now adopted in our institute, and also we always call for all the experienced people to come and to participate with us in our training courses, and alhamdulillah, thanks God, we have a very, very good reputation, not only in Egypt but also in the Arab world, by which we can arrange a lot of training courses for the Arab media people, Arab journalists also, and we have a good reputation in that, and thank you, God. This is good.
As a child in one of the Suez Canal cities, Dr. Hassan Abu Talib talked about 1967 defeat and how he and his family faced it.
I am from a family from Ismailia. Ismailia, this is the city in the middle of the Suez Canal. As you know, everybody knows the three Suez Canal cities, Port Said, Ismailia, Suez. And all these cities have suffered a lot, especially in the era of the occupying the occupation of the Israelis in Sinai. And we, after June 1967, we enforced to move from our cities to the other cities in internal. To be away from the what we can say the bombs of the Israeli and all the the raids of the Israeli airplanes, and that time this was the policy of Egypt under the Nasser era, in which between 1967 until 1973, the October 1973. This is the famous war which launched by Egypt and Syria in the plan to liberate our occupied land. In this area, in this time, all the people from the three canal cities suffered a lot, because we moved from our cities, and yes, there were some kind of cooperation from the government. There were a lot of what we can say interesting policies and situation from the places which we enforced it to move to. In that time we moved with my family to many places. I moved to Banha and lived about a few months, and then we went to Mansoura, and also about 1 year Tanta, Zagazig, and also many Al-Amh. We moved in this time about 7 years in about five cities, major cities. And this is built up our new experience, because as you know, in the cities of the canal, we famous to be an open society, because we touches our relation with the foreigners. But in the cities like Azagadig in that time, Banha in that time, Mansoura in that time, it was an internal cities, which more conservative, and also the relation with the foreigners are very, very limited. Sometimes it was not existed at all. And in this time, there were a rare societal change in the relation of the citizens, the Egyptian people themselves. Because we came with our experience of an open society, and we went to conservative societies. What we can say, the conflict of social behavior, and also experience, and also thinking, the way of thinking, and also our suffering from the Israeli aggression, all this combination of experience helped the Egyptian society, not only the people came from Suez or Ismailia or Port Said, it changed their behavior, but also we learned a lot from the new conservative society which we are lived in. In that time we changed our experience. They also asked ourselves about how you do that, why you are behave in this situation like that. And we asked the same. After a while, a new Egyptian society had been raised on. Why raised on? Because the interchange of the different and conflicting behavior will happen for a lot of time, 7 years in that time. Anyway, this gave us a lot of experience and gave us a chance, a very, very big and excellent chance for us to know the other. In the time we consider ourselves one self, and the new conservative society the other, and it's the same, they consider us as the other. But anyway, we were Egyptian. They were in that time a very, very unique and very, very important goal for all the Egyptian society, government, the leadership. It was the Nasserist, as you know, leadership, which all of us, we are interested to gain, how to free our occupied land. And in that time, the voice of the liberation battle was the first. No other voice should be raised in that time. And the society, the government, and also the leadership of Nasser in that time, all of this mixed together, there were a combination, a very, very excellent combination between all these factors. And I think this has helped the Egyptian to continue challenging the occupation, the Israeli occupation. All the pressure that came from the United States in that time and the Western countries in that time upon us, and also to attract what we can say a good cooperation with the Soviet Union in that time, in military, in economic, in political meaning. And this helped the Egyptian people, the Egyptian leadership, to face the Israelis, and also to prepare the society to the big event, the October War, which it was a very, very unique event in military meaning and also in strategic and diplomatic meaning in the time, which helped the Egyptian to free our land in Sinai. And also after that we found ourselves enforced again to move, not to what we can say a strange society for us, but to original society for us. But in that time we were fulfilled with a unique experience, the experience of internal hijra, or internal move inside the Egyptian local community. The Egyptian faced not only a horrible but also something good, something bad. I was in that time as a child about 10 years old. In the first days, or let me say in the first months after the full occupation of Sinai and the full withdrawal for the Egyptian army from Sinai, the Israeli continued bombing all the canal cities. I remember that the Israeli continued to bomb Ismailia about 10 hours every day. Can you imagine? You are trying to keep yourself to go to the a place. You imagine that this place is away from the bombs of the Israelis. And also there are a lot of Israeli planes came and bombing your cities, your societies, your streets, your infrastructure. And in that time we faced a lot, really faced a lot. A lot of people have been died, and I remember many things. It's like when the Israeli bombed the railway station in Ismailia. I don't remember the date, but it was about 1 month after the full occupation of Sinai, and they bombed the train of 2 o'clock. As you know, that this train was always full of people whom finished their work and go to the local communities near about the major city Ismailia, 10 kilometers, 15 kilometers, something like that. In that time, they bombed the railway station and they bombed the train. It was full of people. And a lot of people had been dying, and I was in that time about 10 years old. I realized that there's a big event. I should go and to try to help those people whom have been bombed. I found myself among a lot of, I can say, not a young people, but a grown people. We try to see whom had been killed, whom had been injured, how we can help. In the time I found and I watched a lot of dead people, and I collect some dead people by myself in that time. We also, after 2 or 3 weeks, the Israel continued bombing the middle of the city. And in one of bad and very, very bad event, in one day my father had been injured, and also my